change in plans. As far as my routing goes, so I actually needed to finish out my 10-hour break instead of starting an hour and a half ago. So, the plan now, I crunched the numbers, the route that Prime, so it's actually kind of funny, there's two different programs we run to get our routing for loads. There's the basic, this is my current amount of fuel, this is my current amount of fuel, this is where I want to go, this is how many miles per gallon I'm getting, tell me where to stop. And that sends us our basic point-to-point routing for our loads. But we've also got a I need directions to this location button, which provides specific info for how to get from, usually from the nearest freeway to a place where we load or unload. And for one of the first times that I've had this happen, they did not agree. The Prime routing put us on Interstate 80 all the way across the country. Put us on Interstate 80 all the way into Pennsylvania, and then had us take a couple of small local Pennsylvania roads directly to the receiver. It's a Walmart distribution center near Hazel. And so it wanted us to use Pennsylvania 54 and I think 901 to get from Interstate 80 down to Interstate 81 to get to the distribution center. In the directions for the distribution center, it explicitly says, do not go that way, it's a dangerous road. So, like, alright, well, it's 20 miles extra to go around on I-80 to I-81. And I'm like, what if I tried to find a way to just be on I-81 instead? So I crunched the numbers, and for another 25 miles, we can just take Interstate 72 via Indianapolis, then pick up Interstate 76, Interstate 72, Interstate 70, Interstate 76, and then Interstate 71. It's only 25 extra miles versus going all the way around at the end like we were going to. And we get the added bonus that it avoids Chicago. And a boatload of toll roads. So that is now our plan. Cleared it with dispatch. They were actually pretty excited I found a route without tolls. So I suspect this will save them a good chunk of money on this load, because I'm pretty sure this load had like a couple $100 worth of toll roads on it. So I don't know how they split that up between Prime and Palmer. I think Palmer pays the I think the way it works, at least with other advanced fleets, is that Prime pays for 2/5 of the toll price because they own 2 of the axles that you're driving, and most tolls are based on axles. So I think that's how it works. But either way, I'm probably going to save the company a bunch of money by going this way. And it's about 50 miles extra from the shortest possible route, and about 25 miles extra from the detour safe route, the way that Prime initially wanted me to go. So only really 25 miles extra, and that's gonna save us a bunch of time, I think. And we're gonna make up the half hour that I lose by doing 25 extra miles. We're gonna make that up just avoiding Chicago alone. So yeah. Plus we also don't we'll save a bunch of time not having to slow down and stop for toll roads. There's a bunch of the toll booths on I-80 are like 5 mile an hour toll booths. Plus they're doing a lot of construction on the on I-80 in Indiana, I believe. Welcome to Lincoln, Nebraska. Been a good little while since I actually brought you guys in to a video while we were here in town. This is one of the denser urban areas that we drive through. On a regular basis, at least. And frequently, shippers and receivers are in busy parts of cities, but Lincoln is one of those few cities where you just kind of have to drive through it a lot. Nebraska Highway 2. We are eastbound. Heading for, we're heading for Percival, Iowa. It's a lovely, lovely city, Lincoln is. Though we've got like 8 stoplights in a row to deal with. as part of this particular route, which sucks, but it's not the worst thing. Oh, I like a little level thing on there, on that door. But you are not on a level surface. Yeah, that's the one downside of going through Lincoln is a lot of stoplights. And if you get bad enough luck, you can get stuck in Lincoln for like 30 minutes just trying to get through all the stoplights. Which looks like we might be on track 4 today. We've hit 2 stoplights so far. The one at the top of the ramp. And this one. We've also got 2 green lights, so that's not too bad. So far we're batting about 50%, which seems to be about my average going through this town. I do like driving through Lincoln. I'm the driver that's really careful about this town. This is a town where you can get into some trouble with a truck. The yellow lights are long, but not crazy long. And if you try and do the speed limit through town, you'll find yourself blowing reds. Gotta stay a nice healthy speed under the limit to give yourself plenty of time to stop when you come up to the lights. That's the important part about Lincoln. A couple of the lights on here have these handy dandy little advanced warning things that warn you before the light goes yellow. Those are really nice. You can actually do the speed limit through those because they give you enough time to stop even if you're doing 55. They're only on the last two stoplights though. Can y'all see it? I don't even know if you guys can see it. The sign for the Loves, where we're hopefully going to be spending the night, sticks above the trees, and you can see it right as you come around that curve, like a beacon in the distance. I like to imagine that it's kind of the excitement that that old-time shippers used to feel when they finally saw a lighthouse on the horizon, or something similar, some sort of beacon. It's a good feeling. We got a pretty amazing sunset going behind us. Unfortunately for y'all, that's not visible. Y'all might get to see a little bit of it as I'm trying to park. I do not know. If there are no spots available, we're going to pull into the fuel island. I'm going to clean the window, go inside, use the restroom, pick up some drinks, and then we're going to leave again. Unfortunately, I do have backup plans. We will need to kill at least about 30 minutes. At least 30 minutes at this place so I can get my hours back. Actually, I don't know if I've got any hours to get back at this point. I might be running out my 11 instead of my 8. I do not know. We'll check when we stop. They'll let me know if I have to try and kill 30 minutes moving around that parking lot, or if I can just continue onward. We've got at least 2 backup parking spots. Possibly a third that I can get to. I don't know. It would be difficult. Alright. There she blows! Please let there be parking. Ugh. I'm gonna be so bummed if there's nothing there. Whoops. Left my engine brake on. Sorry, Maxwell. I'm not doing very good at the shifting thing today. I play in the city of Lincoln. That always throws off my game. Flatbeds in those spots that I cannot see from this angle. I do find it slightly humorous that we wind up visiting this place so much. Oh, look at all these spots right here. Oh, fantastic. We're going to get a nice easy one. No, we're not getting a spot over there. There's cattle haulers parked there. Which means we're just gonna park here next to our Swifty friend. No. Oh, that's a 2018 Cascadia. Nice! I've seen a lot of those today. It's like they just suddenly started popping up in everybody's fleets. I've seen a CR England. 2018. I've seen a Pride Transport out of 2018. And some company that's got some beautiful blue ones. I saw one of those. Are any of y'all reefers? You are not a reefer. I try not to park next to non-reefers if I can avoid it. Just because it's not polite. Park next to Maverick. I like the Maverick Reefer folks. They're nice people. perfectly. It's always in a situation like this, we've got all the room in the world. Move over to the right just a hair. Y'all can see a little bit of the sunset. Like I should actually move over right next to the Maverick truck, but probably not. This is probably fine. Aww. This guy's got an adorable pit bull. You guys probably noticed the dog before I did. I think he was walking him in the grass. Alright. Should I move over next to Maverick? To make this spot easier for someone else later. Somebody else's life easier later, probably. So anyway, I'm done for the evening. We all asked my favorite loves in Bevier, Missouri. It's kind of north central Missouri, maybe an hour west of Hannibal. If I, at least at the speed I drive. My name's Ollie O'Dare, AzerAngel17 on Twitter, Xbox Live, and Steam. Drop in, say hi, see what I'm playing. Twitter's the best way to get a hold of me, of course. You can also leave comments below the videos. Those all push to my phone, and I see them and read them all. If you enjoy the videos, hit the like button. That helps me pop up in recommended results and stuff and helps my channel grow. That is always appreciated whenever you do that. If you don't like the videos, hit the not like button. I don't know if that does anything, but it makes you feel better. I apologize for the audio issues we had all last week and possibly into this week. I've got a solution for that coming soon once I get home next. Anyway, my name is Ellie O'Dare. Subscribe if you want to see tomorrow's videos and have a great day.